give us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord, a word from the
Lord. Be merciful, but there are some folks that are not in Haiti, and they're not nearly going through the survival that is going on in Haiti, but in their everyday life they are struggling through the situations, and they're feeling rejected, and they feel as if God has not shown them the favor that they once had. They feel as if God has forgotten to be merciful or compassionate in their everyday life, as they deal with their mates, as they deal with their children, as they deal with their work and their bosses and people that work up under them. They can easily come to the same kinds of conclusion in their everyday life. Even folk that work at the church can begin to feel rejected and feel like God is not showing mercy, that God is not being everything that he should or could be in the church. But wherever you are, if you're struggling today, we want to give you the keys to really meditating on the word of God. And the key to meditating on the word of God is to remember that the word of God is really describing who God is.
That's it.
It's not just the words on the paper, and the power is not just in the word itself. The power is in the God that the word describes.
All right.
And so you have to remember that this is not just a study, an intellectual study. This is a spiritual study of who God is. And if you're going through a hard time tonight, we want to challenge you that you need to be musing on the Almighty. Musing simply means to be reflecting, to be meditating. Musing, to remember. And again, verse 7 says, I will remember the deeds of the Lord. Yes, I will remember your miracles of long ago. See, one of the things that I like to know about the miracles of long ago is that, you know, miracles don't mean anything to me long ago, but I need a miracle right now. And one thing that Christians do when they muse on the Almighty is that this is a testimony that God enabled us to have through his word, is that God is a miraculous God. Say to your neighbor, neighbor. God is a miraculous God. He's still the same miraculous God of long ago.
Yep.
Of long ago. I like what C.S. Lewis had to say. See, he says, the mind which asks for a non-miraculous Christianity is a mind in process of relapsing from Christianity to mere religion. Our God is a miraculous God. Our God is an all-powerful God. Our God is a God who is able. Say to your neighbor, neighbor. Muse this. God is able. This is what the psalmist had to do after he had questions, after he struggled in his faith, like a butterfly in a cocoon has to struggle to break out of the cocoon and to be metamorphosized. And we see in the text that the psalmist is being metamorphosized. At one moment he was depressed and dejected and down and lonely and posing questions to God, and the next moment he's remembering who his God is, and he's taken from that little cocoon of struggle and of darkness, of seeming like life doesn't mean anything, seeming like my life is not going anywhere, that I'm locked away and I can't be loosed. Now knowing that it's in the struggle that you bore the wings so that you can be metamorphosed prophesies and said that when you come out, you can fly.
Yeah.
Say to your neighbor, tonight, I'm coming out.
Amen.
And that's what the psalmist then he said, right after he was dejected down in the press, he said that this is what I'll do. I will remember the deeds of the Lord. Yes, I will remember your miracles of long ago. So when we go through a hard and a bad time, we have to muse, or musing to remind them. We have to be musing to remember. To be musing to remember. The text says what? The text says, I will meditate on all your works and consider all your mighty deeds.
Well.
I will meditate. I will begin to remember that meditation is not the emptying of the mind and becoming one with the universe and sitting around humming.
All right.
No, that's not biblical meditation. Biblical meditation is putting the word of God in your mind so that you can remember who your God is.
Yeah.
That's true meditation. If you were doing your reading today, in the book, we were reading about Isaac when he was walking out over the fields, and some translation says that he was meditating before his wife would then show up. He was musing in that field after the death of his mother, theologians think. And God, even as he was meditating on who he was, sent him a wife to minister to him after the death of his mother. Today, God wants somebody to muse to remember. Because if I pose the question, what has God done for you lately? You may not be able to say that God has done anything miraculous for me today. But if he did anything miraculous for me yesterday, you may be listening and you don't have a testimony. But even if you don't have a testimony, God is,
yes, he is.
A miraculous God. God. And then you have to meditate on his mighty deeds. Let's go and let's think about God's mighty deeds. When you think about God's mighty deeds, I think about the miracles in the Bible, I have to start in Genesis.
Yeah.
And think about God, the God of creation, where God in the beginning said, let there be, and there was.
Yeah.
And God, as we muse on who God is, God, this is the principle, go back. This is the principle, something, God can make something out of nothing. The Hebrew word that uses of God in creation is a word that it says that it sounds like ex nihilo, that means that God made something out of nothing. I can look and marvel at what all that men can do within our day and time. Every time I fly on a plane, I think it's a marvelous thing, the jet engine. And I look and I see some of the great buildings that are built, that man has built. But I see the only limitation of men is that they have to have something to create something.
Well.
See, that's the limitation of man. But God stepped out of nowhere and called that which was as if it always had been.
Well.
And he said, let there be.
Well.
And created something,
yes,
out of nothing.
Yes.
That encourages me today that God can make something out of nothing, because I didn't come from a rich family background. As a matter of fact, my family were sharecroppers. And if I want to do something miraculous and marvelous in my life, I can't do